What's going on, guys? Sean here, back again to spill more information to you guys. I promise you guys, here pretty soon we'll get a vlog out, you know, apart from me just talking to you guys and actually doing some cool things. But today I wanted to talk to you guys about a question that a lot of people ask me throughout social media or in person. And that question is going to be, how do I keep myself motivated to continue going to the gym day in, day out? And there's really going to be a couple different answers to that question. I would say that the first thing I can say is going to be, whenever I first started to get into resistance training or weight training and I started to see progress, that was a huge motivator. Going from this small stick figure that I had and actually being able to put a little bit of muscle mass on, start to see some definition within my body, that was a huge motivator for me. And from the second that I saw progress from working out, you could pretty much say I was hooked. I started to do it every day. I would do the same routine over and over and over again every day after school, after basketball practice, because I really, really wanted to see more progress. I wanted to see just how far I could take things. So that right there, progress in itself is a huge motivator for me. Now that I've made quite a bit of progress, I would say, I mean, progress is still a motivator, but there's other things out there that help to keep me going also. And one of those is going to be that I am honestly, I am truly afraid of an average lifestyle. And me saying that, you might be like, okay, well, how is being afraid of an average lifestyle going to push you into the gym? And to that, I say, fitness is what I love to do. Fitness is what I want to do. And fitness is the only thing I can see myself doing. Is the fitness industry an easy industry to get into? Obviously not. I still haven't made it. But here I am. I'm still working for it. So at the end of the day, I would love to be a fitness influencer, to have an impact on people who are looking to get into fitness. Like, that is my dream job. You can hardly even consider it a job, because it would be such a great opportunity to have. And that keeps me motivated as well. So obviously, if you're trying to get into fitness, you want to be an influencer. You have to look the part. So even on the days where I'm feeling tired, I'm feeling sluggish, you know, I don't want to go to the gym, I keep in mind my end goal. I know what I want to do at the end of the day. So I make sure that I get up and head to the gym and get what I need to get done. Now, me being afraid of an average lifestyle has been something that's been pretty consistent, actually. So, for example, whenever I go, which is not that often, but if there's been moments where I go to, like, a Dallas Mavericks game, and I'm sitting in the stands, and everybody around me is enjoying the game, but then I kind of start, my mind starts to wander elsewhere, and I start thinking about all the hard work that these NBA players put in to get into the spot that they're at right now. Because I know whenever they're done with that game, they're going to be living quite comfortably. They're not struggling with money. I'm not saying their life is easy by any means. That's not what I'm getting at. But they're definitely not living the average lifestyle. And they didn't get there without hard work. So that is a motivator for me, believe it or not. I can't just sit back and watch, like, these professional athletes and just enjoy the game like most people do. In my mind, I start thinking about everything they've done to get to the spot that they're at now, because that's where I want to be. I want to be up there in a spot similar to theirs. Not necessarily, I don't want to be a professional basketball player. I don't want to be a professional football player. That's not what I'm saying. But I want to be at the top of the fitness industry. You know, I want people like Simeon Panda, who I would say is my biggest influencer right now. Simeon Panda, Ulysses, Bradley Martin. I want these people to know my name. I want to be able to go catch a session in the gym and lift with these guys like it's nothing. And I think I am perfectly capable. So for you, I mean, you have to have a similar mindset. You have to think, if you're going to do something, you don't want to do it halfway by any means. You want to make sure that you're going 110%, pushing yourself towards your goals, so that you can be at the top of whatever it is you're going for. And that could be something completely unrelated to fitness. Whatever it is that you love to do, you should be looking to see if there's any possible way to make a career out of it, because there's a good chance you can. Now, I'm not saying it's going to be easy. I'm not saying you're going to make it happen anytime short term. It could definitely be a long, drawn out process. But you have to be willing to work for that. Just like I'm currently willing to work for my place in the fitness industry. And hopefully I can continue to push and, you know, make some waves. Other things that motivate me is just health, really. So living in America, I mean, you can go to Walmart, look around the store, and it's truly, to me, upsetting how many unfit, unhealthy, obese people you see in the world. And I mean, all of them have a different story, of course. They all didn't get there the same way. Some of them just a lack of knowledge of how to eat. Some of them too busy working. It's a pretty common excuse. There's a bunch of different ways that it can happen to anyone. And I'm not being judgmental towards those people, but I do want those people to understand that they have the ability to make a change. And I don't want to end up in that same situation. I want to stay on top of the curve, making sure that I'm keeping myself as healthy as possible now, so I don't have to worry about it later whenever I'm 40 or 50 years old and it's going to be that much more difficult to get myself in the gym, especially if you're just getting started. So long-term health is a huge motivator as well. Another thing that I would like to say within this video is that you will always be able to go into or onto YouTube and find motivational videos to help motivate you to do whatever it is you're working towards. However, the motivation that you receive from videos such as this one, if this moves you in any particular way, is going to be what I consider short term, because something like this might get you into the gym, but it's not going to keep you into the gym. So I might be able to motivate you to go to the gym today, but there's a good chance you won't be able to watch this video over and over and over again and continue to receive that same motivation. Eventually, it's going to lose its effect on you, and you're going to have to find another source. So if you're looking for long-lasting motivation, in my honest opinion, that motivation is going to have to be found within. People always asking me, you know, how do I stay motivated to go to the gym? How do I stay motivated to stay fit? And in all honesty, my response is, how do you not? You have one body for all that you know to take care of. And this body is going to be with you for the rest of your life, for all of your life. It is who you are. So would you not want your body to represent a healthy you? Because I've come to learn that this is me, so I'm going to do whatever it takes to make sure that I'm exactly where I want to be physically, mentally, and emotionally. I know that I need to take care of myself before I can do anything else. At times, I think it is okay for you to be selfish and say, hey, I need to take today to make sure that I'm doing okay. If you're struggling with something in your mind, I mean, just take a day, relax, think about it, think what you need to do to fix whatever situation that you might be in, to help better your situation. If you're not happy with your body physically, I mean, that's going to be a huge effect on everything you do in your daily life. If you cannot look in a mirror You don't know what I'm looking at, but there's a mirror right there. If you cannot look in a mirror and be happy with yourself, then, I mean, every morning, whenever you're getting ready, you're going to see yourself in the mirror and automatically be in a worse mood than you could have been had you decided to have taken care of yourself and be comfortable in the skin that you're in. Now, obviously, I'm not saying that everyone needs to have the body of some Greek god or whatever that may be, but I'm saying that you should definitely be comfortable in your body, because if you're not, why? Why aren't you? Only you can change what you're living in, and you have that ability unless you have some sort of disability, which is like the one outlier in this situation. So if you're pursuing something and you're looking for motivation within something else, my suggestion to you is going to be ask yourself why you started doing what you're doing. Whenever you started on your process of growth and whatever it is you're pushing for, what made you begin? What were you after? And continue to think about the end goal. There's definitely going to be obstacles getting in your way. It's never just a straight road to success. That's just not how it goes, unfortunately. But remember why you started, and then dig deep inside yourself to find reasons to keep going. Because if you're looking for external sources of motivation, like I said, they are going to be short-lived. They won't continue to push you as far as you can yourself. And that is the biggest point of this video. If you're looking for motivation, you need to find what drives your mind. Because what pushes me is not going to be the same thing that pushes you. And that's just how it goes. But with that said, I appreciate you guys watching. I hope I was able to move you in some sort of way, continue you on a path to success. And I appreciate the support. Honestly, I appreciate everything you guys are doing for me. If you're checking out my vlogs every time I put them out, thank you so much. Hopefully we can get some growth here pretty soon and continue to do great things. If you like the content, check out my Twitter, check out my Instagram. More so my Instagram than anything else, to be honest. But I'll definitely put links down below. And I appreciate you guys watching. Thank you so much. See you next time.